Between the hyper-expensive town of Winter Park and the regular, Colorado-level expensive town of Empire, lies a 24-mile stretch of US 40 rising to a maximum elevation of 11,307 feet. This pass, named for and discovered by the chief surveyor of the Colorado Central Railroad, Edward L. Berthoud, is a bustling hub of winter sports. This is Berthoud Pass. The vicinity of this area has everything Colorado has to offer in microcosm. From here, you are minutes from skiing, hiking, snowmobiling, camping, fishing, falling off a cliff taking a selfie, picnicking, wildlife viewing, skiing, biking, and tearing your ACL trying to ski, if you're me. And while there's plenty to do up here year-round, the winter is when the pass really gets a sense of personality. The parking areas choke with Subarus and hybrids, the hillsides are covered with the graceful swishes of backcountry skiers and boarders. Those same boarders and skiers can be seen hitching rides back up the pass, usually in Subarus and hybrids, and the warnings given by conspicuous orange signs warning use of weaponry for avalanche mitigation become very real. And while Berthoud Pass had its own dedicated ski area until 2002, the current lack of one seems to have been no hindrance to the more ardent practitioners of the sport. And even for the more casual, less dedicated, or more well-off, the popular ski area of Winter Park is a mere 15 minutes from the summit of the pass. In addition to skiing and snowboarding, there is a gamut of other activities and points of interest along the way, many of which merit and will one day get videos of their own, and are as follows with their approximate location. For trails, we have the PA Educational Research Trail, Ruby Gulch, Urad Lake, Hassel Lake, Butler Gulch, Stanley Mountain, Colorado Mines Peak, Mount Flora, Second Creek, Bonfils Stanton, and Jim Creek. For water features, we have Berthoud Falls Cascades. It's more impressive in the spring and the summer. And even though there aren't pull-offs for a lot of others, there are more than a few along the road that you'll see just driving up and down during the summer and spring. There are a few dedicated camping sites along the way, all closed during the winter. They are Mizpah, Robber's Roost, Midland, and Idlewild. The two dedicated picnic areas are Clear Creek and Big Bend. And some other points of interest, most of these will get videos of their own, are Jones Pass, Corona Pass, Henderson Mine, Urad Lake, and Winter Park. If you do decide to take a trip either to or through Berthoud Pass, there are more than a few hazards to take into consideration while traveling. Obviously some of these apply in the winter, but others apply year-round. During the winter, avalanches and snowslides, both planned and unplanned, can shut down the pass for hours depending on the severity. Roads can be treacherous in a storm, and as such, all-wheel drive or winter tires are recommended. People can be parked straight up in the middle of the road, as I experienced twice in a single session of filming. Like, these people right here just chilling right there on the side. Okay. People can be hitchhiking, and as much as I hate to say it, flatlanders can't drive in snow. I'm looking at you people from Florida. You can send rockets into space all day, every day, but driving in the snow is not your forte. During the summer, all these apply except for snow issues. Hitchhikers and flatlanders to a lesser extent, though you will see more people parked in the middle of the road to look at moose, and you may discover that while Coloradans can drive in the snow, we cannot for the life of us figure out how to drive in the rain. Also lightning. Don't be on the top of a mountain in a thunderstorm. And people with RVs that don't pull over, even with 30 cars stacked up behind them. You know who you are. In addition, less of a hazard and more of a time management issue, pass can and does get clogged on the weekends, more so in the summer than winter, but still something to take into consideration if you're making plans passing through. Anyway, even if you are some aberrant Coloradan that doesn't like things like skiing, tearing your ACL or hiking, the drive alone is worth taking at least once, just for the scenery. And if you're from out of state and you do love all those things, it's not likely something you'll forget the first time you travel it. I know, because I see you posting it to your Instagram. To get there, get on I-70 and travel east or west until you get to exit 232. Safe travels, and I'll see you next time.